Warning tonight for dog owners. The FDA is investigating whether a popular diet trend may be putting some pets at risk.
Sharon Tay joins us now in studio with those details tonight. Sharon.
Yeah, it is an increasingly popular trend for pets. Grain-free food, we hope, makes them healthier. But could going grain-free do more harm than good in some dogs? The FDA and some veterinary researchers are investigating. Delaney and Blue are treasured members of their family, so their owners, Rob and Carol Salmon, wanted to feed them the best, which for years they thought was Nutrisource's line of grain-free chicken and pea blend kibble. Now, there's an industry-wide investigation into the possible connection between grain-free food and a form of heart disease called dilated cardiomyopathy, or DCM.
It was a shock because they seemed normal. They seemed absolutely okay.
But Delaney and Blue were sick. They tested positive for a taurine deficiency. Taurine is an amino acid critical to healthy heart function.
It's prevalent in meat sources of protein, but when you use vegetable sources of protein, it may not be as bioavailable.
In other words, says Culver City vet Dr. Jeffrey Werber,
it's one thing to eat a protein, but how's that protein broken down, and can they use all the byproducts of those proteins?
The FDA is investigating 158 cases of DCM linked to grain-free dog food nationwide, and vets around the country are doing studies of their own. One theory, it's not the lack of grains in this food making dogs sick, rather what companies put in place of it. Sweet potatoes, peas, and other legumes might be stripping a dog's ability to absorb taurine. For now, that's only a theory. It hasn't been proven.
It's not a complete common denominator, and that's what makes it so confusing.
In a statement, Nutrisource said it follows and will continue to follow recommendations by the FDA and pet nutrition experts, adding in part that pets are family, and we would never knowingly provide products that could harm them. The company also started supplementing its diets with taurine in hopes that it will aid dogs, whether they are predisposed to DCM or already have it. Sometimes that works. It did for Blue. It did not for Delaney. Her heart was already too damaged. Symptoms of heart trouble in a dog?
Coughing, exercise intolerant. You might see some fluid buildup. He's just an allergic disaster.
Dr. Werber says while suspected allergies are a leading reason owners go grain-free in the first place, believe it or not,
most animals are not allergic to grain. In fact, of all the allergies that affect dogs, foods are probably maybe 15%.
Just like people, dogs can be allergic to dust, pollen, and
some dogs, believe it or not, are allergic to cats. Some dogs can be allergic to their people.
Symptoms of a true food allergy?
They're going after their feet like crazy, licking, licking, licking. And oftentimes, they'll be rubbing their faces against the wall.
Dr. Werber says before you eliminate any food group, see a vet or a pet nutritionist and ask about their diet
to make sure that it's balanced.
And keep in mind, there is no one brand that's been singled out. Rather, it's the ingredients common in many grain-free foods that are being investigated, primarily beans, peas, and potatoes. Are they as good for our pets as they are for us? Well, the results of the first studies should be out in a few months. Susie and Jeff, now back to you.
They are just like our family.
Yeah, some really good information there, too, Sharon. Thank you.